is open after this. Try and get what you can from Joel and Kenny so you can go to the locker and get the other guys, please.
Steve, I will take another statue if you've got one, please.
It's all marked up, Coach.
All right, I'll give it back to you. Well, it's a much... much better night for us because of two guys sitting up here with me. I thought Kenny was absolutely sensational. And the best thing about it is he was not selfish for 1 second during the course of the game. He's 6 for 8 from 3 in the first half, 7 for 10 total, and he took 1 shot in the second half. And to me, that's the way a basketball player, I can't say enough about what I thought he did for us, and not just shooting the ball in the basket, but to be that unselfish, you're caring about your team, that's sensational. Joel, I like that, 10 for 19 now. That makes him 11 for 30 this year, so I really like that. After going 1 for 10 last game, I thought he'd bounce back and shoot it well. He came over early today before the game for our shoot around. This morning, got some extra shots up, and he's one of the hardest workers I've ever coached. These two guys up here were really something. Luke didn't have the kind of game he's been having, yet he still got 9 rebounds, had 5 assists. I was mad at halftime. We had the same number of rebounds. We out-rebounded by 10 in the second half. I thought we defended better in the second half and really got some quality play. And hopefully the freshmen learned some things tonight. They didn't have much success, but hopefully they learned some things.
Let's try new questions for Joel and Kenny first, please.
All right, guys, both total 11 three-pointers. What were you feeling tonight?
Yeah, you know, Kenny came out and shot the ball great, and you know, he works on it, and we expect that from him. And you know, I just wanted to bounce back from not shooting the ball as well last game, and so I just put up some extra shots. But besides that, I mean, we play hard on the defensive end, and that's why I try to start at, because that gets my game going. And Kenny did the same thing as well. But as far as the fans, you know, we want to thank them a lot, you know, from the Carolina family. When we ran out and I heard how many people were cheering for us, you know, that made me excited for the game, because you go on the road sometimes, it's just you and the team and that's it. And they did a great job of coming out and supporting. So from behalf of the team and myself, we just want to thank them for coming out and supporting us.
Kenny, when you get on that kind of roll the first 9 minutes when you make 6 three-pointers, just what does that feel like? If you can just kind of take me through and you know, how big the basket looked.
I think it was something like that against Radford.
Yeah.
But it was. I think I hit 4 in like 4 minutes. But at that point, like when I first went to the bench, I told the guys, man, I'm just throwing it up there and it's going in. At that point, I mean, you hit a couple shots and you know, the confidence is all there. Confidence is at all-time high. So once you see a couple go in, and you just start shooting, and the basket just seems to get bigger.
Have
so
have you had a streak like that, like high school maybe, or?
No, I haven't. I've actually never made that many threes in so little time in the game ever.
For what you've been through to get back to this point and have that kind of performance, what does that mean to you after the rehab and the, you know, the work you put in the summer?
It means a lot. It just shows that the work is paying off. And then, you know, to come back from the injury and to have that performance, I think it just means a lot to me personally, because, you know, I missed a lot of time. So, yeah, it just means a lot. And I honestly, I don't know what to say about it, to be honest with you.
It was fun.
Yeah.
Coach Williams mentioned you were over here early this morning putting up extra shots. Was that here in Maples? And how many extras would you say you took today?
I probably took about 200 shots.
Before the team got over, you got more with the team, but he came over before the rest of the team.
Yeah.
And before shoot around.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and it's just, you know, you don't have to be in love with working and the work ethic, but whenever you see the results like tonight, I mean, that's what's so great about being able to push and do things when people aren't looking and behind doors, because you go out there on the court, and that's why I started smiling, because I expect to hit shots because I work so hard on it and I take passion in that. And you know, I'm not the tallest and I'm not the biggest, so I have to outwork anybody that I go against. And that's why when I hit the shots, I was just smiling, and it's because I expect to hit those shots, and when they go in, you know, that it's for me and for my team as well. I know I have to be a big time player for the team, and that's why, you know, I just love working out.
Okay, even with all the shots.
How long would that, you know, 200 shots, how long would that take you? What time did you get in here?
I got here about 30 minutes before, and it was a combination of floaters, mid range, three pointer, just to get my touch right. So,
Kenny, even with all the shots, you drew your second charge right in the second half, and you kind of shot up and maybe showed them your most excitement after that. You did the same thing last week. I think you gave your coach some skims over the court. How much is that such a big part of your game on the defensive end?
I would say it's the biggest part of my game. I love to take charges because, I mean, it's a big momentum shift. A team can have all the momentum, but if you go take a charge, it just takes it all away from you. So that's why I get so excited about it, because you see somebody take a charge, risking their body, sacrificing their body. The whole team gets excited, the bench gets up, and you can see coach's reaction. Coach loves it, so I take pride in that. I take pride in taking charges and on defensive end, so it's probably one of the biggest parts of my game.
Take one last one for the players, if there is one, so we don't
Joel,
hold Coach
Joel,
Hass
up. You mentioned taking the various shots this morning. We saw you hit threes tonight, saw you penetrate, saw you with some of the mid-range game. Does that speak to kind of what you worked on this offseason?
Yes, sir, and I spent a lot of time in the gym. And the biggest thing is, you know, I just always think about my freshman year, and that's what motivates me so much, because I want Coach Williams to have the trust and be able to believe in me every time that ball goes up that it's going in. And that's why I work so hard on my shot. And, you know, I'm going to continue to work on it. I can't get complacent because I know there's other guys out there working as well. So, you know, as a big-time player, you can't just sit there and wallow in the performance that I had tonight. I just got to keep pushing and continue to get those shots up. And like I said, if I continue to do that, you know, I expect to hit those shots when I'm going or when I'm in the game.
Thanks, guys.
Joel even got an offensive rebound.
Oh, that. Yeah.
That's my walk you back to the locker room. Questions for Coach Williams?
Is that a little jump hook or just a floater?
It was a floater.
Coach, what were your impressions of the Stanford players, particularly Reed Travis?
I've known, I saw Reed play in high school, thought he was a big-time prospect. He was a focal point of us. We tried to get the team to understand what we had to do defensively. We did such a great job. He only had 21, you know, but he's really a good player. He could drive the ball to the basket. He made a couple of mid-range jump shots and even made a three tonight, so he's a complete player. It was a little difficult for us because our four post players, we got Luke May and the other four guys are all freshmen. And so they had a challenge out there, but I think Reed is a big-time player. I think, was he not second-team All-League last year, something like that?
First team. Yes, sir.
He deserves it. I mean, he's a load for us.
Stanford players are ready, so let's take three quick questions for Coach.
What did you and Jared say after the game?
Oh, at the end, I just, and I don't mind sharing, I told him I was sorry that Jaleek dunked the ball there at the end. We didn't need to do that, and he said that doesn't make any difference. And when it happens to me, it never bothers me either, but I know it does some people. But Jaleek ran, he showed a lot of explosiveness going to the basket. If he had ran back on defense like that, I'd played him more. But there's a lot of personal things today. This was an emotional day for me this morning, talking about Jared. It was emotional when I got up on the bench and started down there because I saw Jared. I don't think I looked at him a single time during the game, but after the game, it's tough.
How valuable was this for the three freshman bigs to go up against some size and some skill that they have?
Well, it would have been even more valuable if they had been successful. But, you know, I worked with the big guys before practice. We had three offensive fouls pushing them. We don't ever do that. So, freshmen are slow on.
So, Coach, I know the standard answer would be this is a new team, but any chance you get this team across the country, you'll be going up the coast a little bit later. How well do you feel that these guys are playing under these circumstances?
Well, under circumstances, you know, it's we'd like to have Cam Johnson. We'd like to have had Joel the first game. So we've had some things like Stanford's going through. There's two guys that would be starting for them right now if they weren't hurt. So you go through this, you feel good about being 3-0. I've seen some good things, but the freshmen have got a long way to go. And before the end of the year, they'll either get better, and I won't have gray hair because I won't have any at all.
Very good. Thank you.
Thank you. Our locker room.